European champion. In lane three, from Ukraine, Maria Kichesova-Skorik. The six-time world champion over 200 metres, Lisa Carrington of New Zealand, is in lane four. 37-year-old Teresa Portela of Spain is in lane five, aiming to qualify for her sixth Olympic Games. In lane six, from Poland, Marta Woltakiewicz, the reigning European champion. Teresa Portela of Portugal is in lane seven, three-time European bronze medalist in this event. Milica Starovic of Serbia, the 2017 world bronze medalist, is in lane eight. And in lane nine, in this women's K1 200 meter final, Inna Klinova of Kazakhstan. And for you, Bernie, this is a massive, massive event, isn't it? The women's K1 200. What a way to kickstart these Olympic qualifiers and these World Championship finals.
Yeah, absolutely. These girls are the fastest girls. 200 meters, it's short, it's sharp. And we have Lisa Carrington in lane four. I believe she did like a 38 in the heat. So we're really going to see some fast times today. Get straight onto the results straight after to see this.
And remember, it's not just about the top three. It's not just about the medals. Five athletes will qualify places for their country at the Tokyo 2020 Olympic Games. And we are underway in the women's K1 200 meter World Championship final. Lisa Carrington aiming for her seventh World Championship title over this distance. And what a start she has got out to. But it is Lisa Carrington, half a boat length lead the New Zealander has already over Portela of Spain in lane five. What an athlete, Lisa Carrington, one boat length lead over 200 meters. She has got clear water now. Keep your eyes though on Teresa Portela of Spain in lane five. Out there in lane one, that's Emma Jorgensen. Gold will go to Lisa Carrington. Spain's Teresa Portela and Poland's Marta Woltakiewicz were definitely up there in the medals, as was Emma Jorgensen of Denmark. But a seventh world title for New Zealand's Lisa Carrington in the women's K1 200 metres, Bernie.
Yeah, my jaw just hit the ground. That was insane. Lisa, wow. Just look at those strokes. If you watch the slow-mo of her start, she is pulling so much water. Wow. And I think that might have been Marta up there. I mean, she's always in the top of the field. So, oh, that's insane. What a new standard. Again, how does Lisa lift again?
Over 200 meters, Lisa Carrington pulled out clear water from the rest of what is an absolutely stacked, quality, world-class field. We saw an absolutely stacked B final earlier, but Carrington, once again, is head and shoulders above the rest. She takes the gold. Silver looks like Emma Jorgensen out there in lane one for Denmark, and possibly Woltakiewicz of Poland with the bronze. Not sure Teresa Portela of Spain was able to hold on to clinch that one, but we're going to have to check out the finish list.
That could have been a tie. That's going to have to be a definite photo finish in that. I mean, earlier in the B final, they were only split by 0.01, and we can break it down right down to that. So, see.
And what a packed stand we have out there already. Just the start of the weekend. It's really filling up. And here we have seven-time world champion Lisa Carrington.
Congratulations. Seven in a row, right? Feels good, I bet.
Yeah, I mean, I won my first K1 200 world championships here 8 years ago, so this means a lot to me.
You're unbeaten since 2011. What does it take?
Lots of paddle strokes and a lot of training, but it's amazing to hear the crowd at the 200 meter mark, and I mean, thanks for everyone for being here. It's really cool.
Congrats, Lisa. Well done.
Yeah, undefeated in a major championship for the last
7 years, 7 world titles now, 2 Olympic titles for Lisa Carrington, and she doesn't show any sign of letting up or slowing down. But remember, it's the medals we're looking out for, and also those top 5 places, because remember, the top 5 in the women's K1 200 will qualify places for their country at the Tokyo 2020 Olympic Games. And Bernie, that's important to remember, isn't it? If an athlete qualifies a place here at the World Championships, it doesn't necessarily mean that that individual will go to the Olympic Games.
Yeah, it doesn't necessarily mean that your name's on the ticket. You're qualifying a position for your country to have as big a team as possible. So it might end up that you go to qualifications and that spot goes to someone else, but you've done your job. Oh, here we are with the results.
Just 0.02 of a second separating second and third, but we have a joint bronze medal between Emma Jorgensen of Denmark and Teresa Portela of